Good morning from Skiathos. We have the first TUI Netherlands former Arkefly. It will be Boeing 737 MAX 8. Expect to land in a quarter or so, runway 01. The plan today is that we stay here to see the landing and then we move to another position to have a view of the airplane on the apron, and then we come back again for the jet blast area from Amaretto. There is also a Sky Express flight from Athens. We maybe keep open the stream till the Sky Express flight, and I hope after those two flights there is a calibration on puppy lights, so we have a Diamond 42 here, calibrator airplane. We fly on airport circuit, so we're gonna have some traffic today. It's not July or August, but okay. The Boeing 737 MAX is approaching Skopelos. In few minutes we'll be entering the coverage of our local DSB area. So we're gonna see it on map. So here we are at the other side of the airport. We will make a close-up on the two light airplanes. The first one is Superior Air. The second one is twin engine. We will zoom it in a few seconds. Supposed to do the calibration of the puppy lights. So we're going to have an airplane flying around on airport circuit today. I don't know how long. For how long? This Diamond 42 arrived yesterday from Samos. Probably they did some calibrations there also. And use a call sign VOR Victor Oscar Romeo 05 during landing yesterday. I guess the MAX did not get any fuel at all for Kefalonia. Probably they do taggering from Amsterdam non-stop to Kefalonia. We see this route for years at Skiathos. Today they changed the flight number with 4-digit 1051. I think it was Arkefly 291 in the past or something like that. So as you see here, the ground vehicle with the follow me, they communicate with the airplane in order to make the adjustments on the puppies for the calibration. Typically, they flying till the minimum of the instrument landing. Then they break off. We don't expect to make a low approach or something. There is no need for them to do so. I'm not sure if they do the calibration till the touchdown. We're gonna see them now. They're turning inbound. If you're watching on a big screen, you probably see the airplane circling go over Skiathos Bay. This is what we expect to do with the calibration. We don't expect to see him closer than that on the runway. rear cargo door is closed. When the front cargo door is closed, we will switch position to the jet blast area of the Amaretto. Manos, no water salute this year. 23 of April was the first flight, but it was probably because of the Easter holiday. We're not supposed to be in celebration, you understand? I believe this is the reason, I'm not sure. We have a lot of time to change position because 737 MAX requires a lot of time to start up compared with the older NG series. So we switching cameras, we're moving, in a few minutes we'll be with you from the other side.
Here we are on the other side now, waiting for the Diamond that TUI is pushing back. this takeoff will be very interesting because somebody from TUI told us that on this runway length, because it's too short, they don't use Tonga. Because as far as I understand, they still have problem with this SEMCAS issue. But they told us that they not use full power. So we noticed last year, Neos Max using all runway. So we're gonna find out now. He's going to Kefalonia, which is very close. He's almost empty of fuel. So we see.
Next landing is Sky Express ATR 72 from Athens. It will be nice, the view with the ferry in the port.